In this video, I'll show you how I color grade underwater footage in LumaFusion. We'll work with four different clips shot on different cameras at different depths because these factors affect how colors behave underwater. We will go through grading without LUTs, with LUTs, how to handle an action camera footage, a mirrorless camera, and also a log clip. Our first clip comes from an action camera. I believe it's a GoPro. And I pick a portion of the clip I like and make sure the scopes are actually visible. If you don't see them, click on the small icon at the top in order to show them. To be honest with you, sometimes I watch the scope more than the image itself, actually. And the middle scope is probably the one I prefer. It shows the full exposure range. Black at the bottom, white at the top. In our clip, everything is sitting a little bit too high, so it looks a little bit washed out. The goal is to expand the range, so we are using the full spectrum from deep blacks to bright whites. I pull the black point slightly left, so I deepen the shadows, then I adjust the brightness to bring the overall exposure down. I watch out for a flight line at the top of the scope. That means highlights are being clipped and we want to avoid that. The contrast is like a gentle S-curve, deepening the shadows and lifting the highlights. So I increase the contrast, but then slightly lift the shadows so I don't lose too much detail in the darker area. I also lower the highlights a little bit to preserve some details in the bright area. At this stage, we can say that the exposure is well balanced and we can move to step number two, the color. So underwater, we lose the red light and the footage often looks green or cyan. So for that, I'm gonna boost the red and purple sliders to recover some warmth. And I bring back a little bit of blue to balance the image. I'm gonna check the tint using the white circle here, but I think I'm going to keep it neutral since adding a strong tint usually is not really helpful. It impacts the whole image and I don't know, not a big fan of it. And finally, I'm going to add a little bit of sharpening to bring back some details, but not too strong, probably around 0.4. That should be enough. And here is the before after, which shows quite a big improvement. Richer black, the highlight is a little bit better also, and a more balanced color. Now let's try to grade the same clip, but this time using a LUT. And the main goal is to save time, making the whole process simpler. And most of the time you actually get a better result. So for that, I need first to import the LUTs. If you know how to do that, you can skip a little bit already, because I'm going to show you how to import those LUTs in LumaFusion now. So first you need to download your LUTs. I have mine stored in Dropbox, so I save them to on my iPad, LumaFusion, presets, LUTs, and then user LUTs. Back in LumaFusion, I open the LUTs tab. I click on the download arrow. I choose files and import them. Now they appear in the user LUTs panel, ready to preview. I start with a clean clip again. I try different LUTs to see which one can give a good base. And the pre-visualization is very useful for that. I think for this clip, I like the Maldavar Underwater Manta 4. Maybe it's slightly dark, but has nice contrast and color separation, which is what I'm looking for. I can use the blend slider to reduce the LUT strength if needed. But here, I think I'm going to keep it at 100%. So now that I applied the LUT, I need to fine-tune. For that, I'm going to bring an original preset. So that doesn't change anything unless I touch to those tools. And the step number one always is to fix your exposure. Step number two is the color. Step number one is the exposure. So for that, I'm going to boost my contrast a little bit by expanding the range. The problem I have here is that it crushes a little bit my shadows. So I boost my shadows a little bit to counterbalance. And now that I'm happy with the exposure, I go to the color and try to tweak it a little bit to see what works. What I like is that the LUT creating a strong color contrast already, but I find the orange a little bit too orange. So I need to counterbalance by boosting my purple, my blue, and the cyan. The color seems a little bit too saturated. That's because we boosted our light contrast and color contrast. So to counterbalance this, I lower a little bit my saturation and vibrance. And for the final touch, like before, I boost a little bit the sharpness, here at 50% maybe. And there you go. Here is a comparison between the raw clip, the color graded, and the version with the LUT. For our second clip, we have a tough one here, I must say. This was shot about 15 meters deep on an 8-bit mirrorless camera. So most of the reds are gone and the scene is nearly monochromatic blue, which is really hate. This is definitely the hardest type of clip to color grade underwater because you don't have any separation in colors. You only have separation in light contrast. So we have dark and white, but we'll see what we can do. I try to find a LUT that will introduce a warm, cool color separation. So the coral and seagrass can regain some orange tone, basically. So some LUTs look too saturated and bright, definitely. And I pick one that at least bring a little bit of orange into the highlight so I can create this color separation between blue and orange. So once I picked a LUT, step number one, again, is to work on my exposure. So I lower the highlight a little bit here to preserve some details. And step number two will be to adjust the colors. So for that, I'm using the color tools available to me. Now I'm gonna try something I usually don't do, but because this clip is such a challenge, I'm actually gonna add another LUT on top of everything to try to bring even more separation. So I'm gonna stack another LUT, and for this one, I'm gonna use the Underwater Aqua 2. I'm gonna put this on top at about 50% strength so I can bring even more red in the scope. And to be honest with you, when I see how little color data we had to start with, I think the final result is quite a big improvement compared to the flat blue original monochrome that we had. So I wouldn't call that perfect, but again, because of the starting point we had, it's quite an improvement already. Now, I want to show you another clip that has been shot on the same dive at a depth that was probably a few meters shallower. It's probably around 10 meters deep here. And as we can see, compared to the previous clip, the starting point is so much different in the sense that we don't have a monochrome anymore. I already have orange available, so I think it's going to be much easier to actually color grade this image compared to the previous one. And then I check the scope and we can see that we have a lot of room in the shadows. So after picking a LUT, I think the one I'm going to use is the Manta 3 for this one. So this is the before after with just the LUT. You can see that the colors are popping. So next I'm going to add an original color preset, which basically doesn't apply anything unless I start modifying some elements. And again, step number one is the exposure. And this time I can try to check what the gamma is doing. So I try to bring the dark a little bit darker. Oh, let's play a little bit with the colors, adding some red. Maybe not. I think I'm gonna leave it here. And again, I'm gonna add some sharpness to that clip. Probably not to the max. I'm just gonna keep it to 0.4. It's probably enough. And there you go. Let's check the before, after. And this is quite saturated. Some people might say that it's too saturated. Which is a personal choice. You could lower the saturation a little bit if you want to. No problem with that. Color grading can be quite subjective. So that's why I think the best is really to give you the tools available. And then from there, you do what you like. Now we're gonna check our last clip, which was shot in log with a 10-bit camera. So we have much more data when it comes to colors. It was shot at the shallower depth, probably around 8 meters, I would say. with the bright afternoon sunlight bouncing off the white sand, which is a great natural reflector. So definitely the conditions that we have here are really nice in order for us to do a good job. So the first step is I'm going to slow down the clip to 40% because I shot this at 60 FPS and I'm editing on a 24 FPS timeline. I'm going to stabilize it also. And when we look at the scope, we can really see that this is a log profile. Most of the data is sitting in the mid-range with a lot of room at the top and the bottom. So I need to expand all this. And I'm going to check the LUTs available for log profile. And I think I'm going to use a Neptune 1 here, which might be a little bit too strong. So I'm probably going to use it at only 70% strength. So I blend it a little bit. So I still have contrast and a nice color separation already. So step number one, again, I fine-tune my exposure. So I pull down the blacks using the levels tool. Can probably adjust the midtones a little bit to bring a little bit more brightness. And I probably increase a little bit the contrast to make full use of the scope's range. And then second step, color. So I can reduce some of the excess orange by boosting the blue slightly. And after playing with the color tools, we can see now the before, after, showing how the lock clip comes alive. And here you have it, guys. So if you want to learn more about underwater color grading or learning more about underwater content creation in general, I do have a course available. Link is in the description. I have LUTs and presets available for photos and videos. Thank you for staying with me until now. Like and subscribe if you liked it and want to see more of those. See you next time.